Welcome to today's video. Today we are going to go over the installation and setup as well as the tools you need for the Alientech Pro case and cable kit for the DJI Mavic 2 smart controller. This is with the quick releases for the signal booster range extender. It gives you the options of using a booster or just the regular antennas. Now let's get into the tools you're going to need for the job. Keep in mind, these are just suggestions for you. The Alientech Pro case and cable kit, a PH000 screwdriver, PH00 screwdriver, and a decent pair of project tweezers that will allow you to get in where your fingers can, and a heat gun or hair dryer. Keep in mind, a hair dryer will take a little bit longer to get the rubber off.
We are not responsible for damage you do to your device. This is only a guide. This modification will void your warranty with DJI, if you have any. Proceed with caution.
Next, you'll want to basically take all your parts, lay them out in front of you, look them over, inspect them for possible damage or cracks, make sure that you're not missing any parts as well, and recognize that you have obviously one with a short wire and one with a long wire. Set all your pieces aside, and next we're going to look at our controller and start taking the actual rubber off the sides of the controller. Use gradual heat, don't try to do it too fast, and be sure to wave it around so that you're not overheating certain areas and causing it to melt, like actually physically bubble, causing damage to it. So just a little bit of heat all over. Grab your pry tool, whatever you might be using, and start carefully separating the rubber from the plastic. This will allow you to squeeze your fingers into the side and work it out off away from the actual plastic. You might find as you're lifting, you might have to add a little bit more heat. Again, gradually wave it around, adding heat only in the areas that are still stuck to the device, and make sure that you don't hold the heat in one spot for too long. Remove any excess 3M that might bunch up and cause it to not lay flat again when you go to reapply it. And set it aside. Inspect the plastic as well. Make sure there's no residue left behind on it. And if there is, clean it up. Next, we're going to remove, if they are still there, the joysticks from the upper compartment on the back of the controller. Moving on to the other side of the rubber, we're going to heat that up and remove that one now, just as we did on the other side. Again, gradual heat. Don't concentrate on one spot. Be sure to wave it all around in even flow and get it nice and warm so it's warm to the touch. This will make you so that the adhesive underneath the rubber is actually getting heated up and you can actually remove it. It softens it up and allows it to come off easier. Once you've started prying it with your fingers and separating it from, flip it over and add a little bit more heat to the back. This allows you to actually remove the rest of it with ease so that you don't actually cause damage to the rubber, and the plastic comes off along with the rubber and the 3M. All is one piece. Again, inspect it. Make sure there's no bubbles, residue that you have to clean up. Next, we have 4 screws on the back that have to be removed. This can be done with the PH00 screwdriver. The ones on the outside are bigger. Grab the PH00, the 000 screwdriver. If you don't have it magnetic, it's handy to put a little magnet on the side of the screwdriver just to help pick up the screws. Be sure to lay them out in the order that you remove them. This helps with the reassemble of the device so that you put the screws in the same place that they came off. You should now have 4 screws removed from the controller on the back. Next, you're going to take out the bottom 2 screws on the back of the controller at the bottom. When removing the plastic cover for the bottom piece, pry tool will be needed and you will carefully lift the bottom of it and then slide it backwards towards the bottom. Set it aside. And now in here we have 4 more screws to remove, 2 on the top and 2 on the bottom. This is when that magnetic screwdriver comes in handy so that you can pick up the screws with ease and set them aside in the way they come off in the same pattern so that when you do put it back together, you have a general idea of where the screws go. Next, when we're going to remove the back cover, the plastic cover, you're going to want to push down on the little tabs on the sides. You can see them kind of fall inside as you're pushing on them, kind of relieving the pressure off the back of the plastic cover. Use caution and do it carefully. Take your time and you, with your pry tool, work them apart. Go all the way around on both sides. Don't try to do one side at once. As you can see in the video, I slowly work away the back cover all the way around, kind of in stages. It is tough. Take your time, be patient, and you don't want to be breaking the tabs. Using your thumb or fingers underneath the cover and applying a little bit of pressure can also help release the tabs inside. You will hear it clicking. Once you have it a ways pop a little bit apart, you can take your pry tool again and give it a little bit of assistance in releasing. Make sure that you try prying the proper way. If you try prying the opposite way, you're actually fighting the clasp. So make sure to pry the right way. Once the bottom is free, the top will be a little bit stuck. All you have to do is put the tool at the top on the sides and go straight up. Remember to use caution here when prying on the back cover. The battery packs on both sides are right underneath that corner, and you don't want to be puncturing your battery. Once it's been released, just set it aside as you will not be using this piece until you reassemble the controller. Next, we have four screws to remove that's holding down the wire from battery to battery. This will be your smaller Phillips. Use your tweezers and remove the black mounts that are over the wire and just set them aside. Next, you're going to carefully remove the connector for the battery. Gently pry from one side to the other. Never pull by the actual wires. The batteries will just lift out of the controller at this point. You can set them aside. Next, we're going to remove the plastic cover and foam that is protecting the antenna connections. There's two screws, top and bottom, on this adapter that you will be undoing and set it aside. Next, using your tweezers, you want to gently remove the antenna connections. This will be done by a slow back and forth motion. This will loosen them as you are lifting up at the same time. They should just click and release off. Be very gentle with these connections as they are easy to squish and damage on the board itself. It's always a good idea to take a picture of the inside of a device when you're taking it apart. Use your phone or whatever you have, and this will give you the idea of where wires went and putting them back. Next, we're going to remove the connections for the dials on the left and right side at the top. Again, same kind of adapter as the battery connector was. You basically go from side to side and carefully disconnect it from the socket that it is inserted to on the board. Once it releases, just lift them up out of the way. And now that all wires are free for the piece that we will be removing, now you have to set the antenna down, put it on its edge, and we're going to pop the top plastic cover off that has the LED plastic illuminators on it. Push down on the button and set your pry tool inside, and with the small gap that you have there, just gently pry up all the way through from side to side. You'll hear it click and it will release. Do the same thing on the other side. Once that piece is up, you can start working on the center clip. The center clip is a little bit tricky. It will almost feel like you're breaking it. Do be careful. You don't want this piece to snap. Take your time. Be gentle. Work your way from side to side. Try all angles and also try both sides. Some will release easier than others, and some will be in there very well. Mine was very tight and it was a struggle to get out. The one side released right away, but that final side on the right hand side was a real tight connection and it wouldn't let go, but I got it. One thing about pry tools, especially metal ones, you never want to stick them in too far and cause possible damage to the circuit board or connectors. So do be mindful of where you're prying, what you're prying. Also keep in mind that a metal pry tool can cause damage to the actual plastic housing. You'll see pry marks permanently indented into the plastic, so use caution. Most of the video provided to you was actual time. It wasn't sped up. It gives you an idea of how difficult some pieces can be, especially when there's no screws. They're just clips. But I wanted to give a realistic idea of how difficult it can be and give you a realistic idea of what's actually involved. Oh, there we go. Finally got it. It almost looked like it popped out really easy there at the end. Next, we're going to flip the controller back over and grab put it on its end and take out the top four screws on the top of the plastic housing. Once you have all four screws removed, place the controller face down, lift the antenna, and we have four more screws to remove on the back. When separating the top plastic piece, it's best to first do the sides. Use a plastic or use a pry tool on the edges and it will click and release. Once you have the sides released, you're going to put a pry tool on the top where you undid those screws to release the top of it. Watch carefully. Once you release it, the top buttons will also be flop around and they will be released. There is a spring underneath there. Be careful not to lose those. There's one spring, and there's the second spring. Set them aside. Be careful not to lose them. Once the sides, you can feel the sides have been released, stand it on edge and just put a pry tool under the top piece of where the screws were that you undid. And it will pop right off. As of now, we are done with the rest of the controller. You can put it aside, out of the way, where it won't get damaged. Next, we're going to remove the dials from the housing, as those need to be transferred over to the new piece that we are putting in. There are three screws on either side. Remove each one of them and place them aside. want to remind you, if this is something that looks like it's not within the realm of your capabilities, you can contact me to have your controller shipped to me, and I will do it for you. Obviously, cost will vary depending on shipping where you are located, but you can contact me to find out that information. When removing the board, it just lifts straight up off the dial. The dial is actually inserted through the center of the board. Next, when removing these dials out of the plastic housing, be very careful. There are two plastic tabs at the bottom being squeezed together with a spring. Now, those back plastic tabs can actually come off of a center post. You'll see in a minute when I go to reassemble it on the other plastic piece, it actually falls apart and I had to put it back together. So just be careful. You do not want that spring to go flying. Those dials basically lift up at an angle and pull out of the socket. That is all for this piece. It is now a spare, a backup, whatever you want to call it. Put it aside. You will no longer need that piece. Take your new one that you purchased. And now we're going to basically do the reassemble process of everything we just did, only backwards. Hopefully this video helped you out, and I appreciate all your support. If you like videos like this, we are always trying to post new videos. And if you are actually looking at sending us something, you can contact us to do so. So this is where the plastic piece actually popped off the center pole. I looked at the other one for example to see exactly how it was set up so I didn't put it back together wrong. It basically just slid back on. You put them all the way down and then place the spring back in between. It has a little groove that it grabs, and it was actually pretty easy. It wouldn't be easy though if you lost any of those pieces. Once you have both pieces put back in, the dials, next you're going to insert the quick release antenna mounts that came with the mount, the plastic cover. One thing to take note is the side that you put the wire on. Take a look at your old piece. Make sure they're laying in the same way and check the lengths of the actual wires. You want to put the length on the appropriate side so that you don't come up short when you put it back together. When placing the piece back onto the controller, make sure your wires are clear, free and clear of being, so they're not pinched. You don't want to be dealing with having a connector being pinched, or make sure they're accessible and make sure they're out in the open. Give them a little wiggle so that they are loose. Next, make sure the buttons are up. You do not want them to seat into the locked position when you snap that together. The reason why, we haven't put the springs back in yet. So keep them up, snap it together, check your seams, make sure everything is closed up and everything lines up. Check your screw holes. And once everything is squeezed together, you can put the springs back and then snap the button down till it clicks. Same thing on the other side. Watch that they stay aligned and then push it down in. When connecting the antenna wires, you want to be extra cautious. Make sure they're actually lined up. Get down low so you can see the actual connector and kind of feel with the tweezers. Give it a little rock back and forth so that you can feel that it's actually on top of the circle. Once you know that you're on top, it'll take a little bit of force to actually push it down on top. You will feel it go down and click on the actual connector on the motherboard. While applying pressure, you can wiggle the cord back and forth and see that it's actually on and made a connection. Do the same thing for the other side. Again, use caution. You damage that connector, it's game over. The wires are tight as far as the angle of the connector, so turn it both ways to feel what has the least tension that's trying to rotate the connector, because you do need it facing a certain way. So just make sure that there's not too much tension on it when you're trying to connect the connector to the motherboard. As you can see, I'm holding down on top of the connector while I move the wire and put everything in place so it doesn't pop off. Once I have everything where I want it, then I rotate it to place the cover back on it with the two screws. After that, then I will run the wires. Because you don't want to be moving the wires around while the cover is off. It could just pop off on you and then you're struggling putting it back on again. in the description, I have a link for the 3M. It's not cheap, but it is heavy duty. You don't have to do it, but it adds that extra strength to it. And you don't need much. Just I just add strength to the edges where the pressure would be wanting to lift. Be careful when placing it. Obviously, it's really sticky, so it's kind of a one-time application, especially once you've removed the paper backing. Warm up the heat gun again. You're going to want to get the adhesive on the back of the rubber very warm. Not to the point where you're going to melt the rubber, but just enough to get that adhesive sticky again. So it'll be warm to the touch on the opposite side of the rubber. Make sure you get one corner in really good so that it lines up. And apply pressure and kind of just work it all the way to the other side. While it's cooling, keep on pushing and applying pressure all over, working out any possible bubbles and so that it seals up. You want to keep doing that until it cools off. Once that side's done, move on to the other side.